forward.
Just going out for a bit of a walk now, a bit of a wander along a nice lane. Apparently there's a wood around here called Blackpool Wood. It's quite a large piece of woodland, we see it from the map, and that's where we're heading now. Don't get many cars along here then, Mark?
No, not really. You didn't hear many in the night, did you?
Didn't hear none.
No. They came off really easy.
We found these oak trees, small oak trees, definitely oak, but on the underside of the leaves I've seen these. I've never seen that before. Never. Isn't that odd?
Quite a juicy interior.
And you see there's others.
I don't really taste of anything.
No, that's really odd. I wonder if it's a wasp, an oak apple with a wasp grub inside it or something, you know?
Oh, it's
well, it's fruity.
Olives?
No, they're not olives.
Oh, I don't know what that is then.
A couple of them.
They look like olives.
I thought perhaps it was an oak apple.
Sloes there?
That's slows, you're not very well formed, are they?
No, they're coming now. No, they're coming from slower gin.
Blackberries. Plenty of blackberries.
We'll all be sitting them where they want as well.
That was a white one.
Christmas day.
Well, we found Blackpool Wood. We're walking around the periphery of it now. It's a large woodland. Rose hips, yeah, we found lots of wild edibles. Of course, this lorry hasn't been moved for many years by the looks of it, and an interesting stone building with the I don't know what the triangular holes are for.
Oh, he's just gone in
there. Well, we're following this track, and apparently this track leads down to an earthwork according to the GPS that Mark's using.
It also says pit this.
Pit disused, disused pit. Maybe that's what it is then.
That's the longest track we're doing. I found most of them, but when
you walk. We walked down to the earthworks, but apparently the earthworks are hidden right in there amongst all the foliage. So we're not going to see the earthworks, unfortunately. But right in the middle of nowhere. Well, Mark's been busy preparing the curry, and I haven't stopped myself. I've been absolutely, I've been flat out cutting up all the wood, and Mark's really been pushing me hard. Haven't you, Mark?
I have, yes.
He's
been great.
He's looked after us well. I haven't had to lift a finger, to be honest with you. But this is our, now it's only 4:15, but we're preparing the curry, and it's sizzling nicely in the Dutch oven there. All homemade. Look at that.
Chickpeas.
Chickpeas have gone in. If only you could smell this. So we've got
tomatoes
going in.
Probably gonna get all the
tomatoes.
And more tomatoes. So you've already pre-mixed the spices, Mark, haven't you?
That's all done yet. All cooked out in the chicken. And the onions, yeah. The garlic, the chilli, the ginger.
Lovely.
Just stir that, bubble, and we take it off and reheat it later.
No, like...
No, a vampire.
No, I don't mean like that. I mean, it was the weirdest thing.
You having a good time, Ars? Are you enjoying yourself? Are you enjoying the rest, are you?
Yeah.
Elsa, have you abandoned me? Have you abandoned me, have you? She's abandoned me. She's your dog now. You've got to feed her, you've got to walk her, and you've got to pay all the vet's bills. What have you got there then, Mark?
This is my thermopen.
Thermopen?
Thermopen, yeah. It gives you a temperature rating or reading within 3 seconds of your food.
Yeah.
So,
if I look in my burgers, I can probe them into the centre. And we're reaching
65 there, 66, 68, that's 63.
So that's got to be 70...
71.
71?
71 internal temperature, and then we know that it's safe to eat.
Safe to eat at 71.
And then they can come straight off. There's plenty of moisture left in the meat. They're not going to dry out or anything like that.
So yeah, very nice.
Lots and lots more flavour.
So we're nearly there.
And we're not going to have any nasty accidents at camp.
No, we don't want that. We've been joined by the future landowners on their quad bike.
Tyler and Luke.
And they're going to show us how they ride their bike. They're going a bit faster, aren't they? Look at it.
Nothing.
They got no date, no fear of danger. Look
at that. Flying anywhere.
We're playing golf football. The object of the game is to kick the ball in as few shots, and you've got to make contact with the there it is. Is that it? Yeah, there it is. With the water bottle over there. Go on, Mark, you got a three. It's a par three at the moment, according to me and Chris.
This is that three. You're at that a six. So here we go. Pretty decent start there.
A good start. Will he do it in three?
Poo-poo.
Oi. Oh. Oh.
No.
Three. No, Mark. Remember when we had that cone? It tasted like.
Oh yeah, it was terrible. I don't know. Let's have a look. See what's happened.
Ooh, that looks rather nice.
Looks okay, doesn't it?
Mmm.
I don't know what you're having. Should be enough for me there.
Ooh, that looks lovely, that does.
Right then, let's dish up. You're going in the billy, can you?
Thank you.
Wow, Sandy.
He's asleep.
More, please, sir.
Drop it, Daka.
God, it has.
And a number, have you?
Yeah, and a mango chutney there as well, if you want mango chutney.
Did that go in it? In the carry or on the number?
Just check it on the side if
you've got
nothing. Come on, yeah.
Just had a nice sunset. Had a nice curry to eat. Mark's looked after us extremely well. Well, I got my Funite torch on my head now, and what do I think of it, having used it? This is its second night now. As I said in my earlier in this video, I have paid for this, I haven't been given it. The only drawback that I think it's got is it's a bit weighty on your forehead. As for battery run times, I don't know yet, because I really haven't used it much, but I think it'd be good. I did use it in Firefly mode. This is Firefly mode. And especially when your eyesight is adjusted to the low level of light or to the darkness. Firefly mode.
I didn't mean moving for that.
Firefly is quite enough for a lot of things. And I know it will last for for many days in this mode. But It does go an awful lot brighter. So there's your firefly. There's your low. There's your medium. There's your low. There's your medium. There's your high. And there's your turbo. Tap it again. And you get your SOS. Back on firefly. And that doesn't, I mean, it's not, you could just about eat food by that, I reckon.
Yeah, that's not too much in your face when you look at someone.
And when I shine it in someone's face, yeah, doesn't dazzle, does it?
No, not dazzling, you can notice it, but
yeah. Yeah, how did you sleep last night?
Like a baby.
Like a baby?
Yeah.
You mean you kept waking up and you shit yourself?
I wonder what that smell was.
No.
You want to know, you okay?
Yeah.
Is she alright?
I think I'm fine.
There's Joey, yeah, just woken up. And there's the peaceful, quiet woods for the last time. We've got to pack up in a minute. The other good advantage of having bought this torch is that I don't have to throw it around like an idiot. You're seeing all the reviews, people are chucking them around, putting them in buckets of water, driving cars over them and all sorts. On mine, I don't have to do that, so I'm not going to do that. It's got a button on the top where you activate it, so that turns it on. As you can see there, it is on. And activates it through all its various modes, which I'm not going to show you anymore. You've seen all those. But the button does protrude, and as such, you could put it in your pack and you could hit that on by mistake. And to avoid that happening, all you've got to do is simply unscrew that a little bit, and that breaks the electrical contact. And so, if you then hit the button, torch doesn't turn on. So when you stow it away in the pack, you can be sure that you're going to have a good battery, and your torch isn't going to get hot or anything. The battery is an 18650, and I got the charger with this, and the charger also doubles up as a device where you can use it to charge from this battery other devices like your phone, for example. It screws on nicely and then it will work. Unscrew it a little bit. Safe to store.